Gareth, thanks for joining me again. This is Scott from Wessex Blades, and I got the initial tabletop review of a Through Night T20 torch. Now, you Corys thinks flashlights in America, but in England, now, chap, this is a torch. So, hey, once you take the outer card off, you've got this sweet little tin. I've got to commend them on a tin, because as with all outdoor people, that is a usable resource. Ranger band around it, you got yourself a survival tin as well. So you got a little bit of silica stuff, keep away from the kids and the pets. It comes in a small little bag. There's the bag away. And what you've got is a torch, a sort of small finger sized. Now, I've got quite a few through nights. One of the most impressive is this one here. Now, I'm into using stuff, using it and using it and using it and using it and using it. I don't mind signs of wear. So, this here, it just shows I'm using this thing every day. It's on my belt every day. I'm clicking it on every day. All right, there it goes. The feature I loved on the T10 is that switch. That switch really feels sweet. Okay, it feels like there's some design in there. It feels robust. I loved it on that torch. Over the moon that the T20 has the same style switch. Now, the power source being this little short stumpy thing, when compared with the T10, T20, T10, you can see that there's a bit of a size difference. It's slightly fatter, only slightly fatter, but we're talking 15 mil shorter, 3/4 of an inch shorter. Power output though, instead of a double A, you got one of these things here. So it's got twice as much voltage and about the same in terms of the current what it can poke out, because I use quite impressive NIMs on there. But that's daylight, okay? I'm here on purpose. That's daylight. There's the window. There's the light on the window. Okay. It's a very powerful little torch. Now the settings is high, low and firefly. And the usual sort of power through, there's your firefly. I can understate the value of a very low output. You can imagine you're in your hammock at night, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and yeah, guys, when you get to my age, you just got to get up in the middle of the night. The last thing you want to do is blast the back of your retinas with 160 odd lumen, and you can't see where you're going for the next 5 minutes. That light setting there gives you, you know, being able to see inside your hammock, being able to look inside the little glove compartment without blasting your face off. Brilliant little idea. Firefly. Now you can cycle through the modes by soft tapping on the cap. So there's the next one. There's the low. And there's blinding. Boom. Firefly. Low. High. Now you've got a pretty wide throw. I mean, that's 45 degrees there, so he's 200 mil off the top of the top there. That's about 200 mil. And you got 200 mil off of the centre. You got a 400 mil spread. So it really casts a wide pool out whilst you've got a spot in the centre. So you're getting some distance and a nice pool of light to see where he would be going. And that's with the light pouring through the windows. what you get in the actual tin. You get this wand. Again, gotta commend Frunite on offering this in the original kit. Other companies, Phoenix, you have to buy these quite often, and that gives you the option of turning it into a lantern. It's a wide base, and even on the sofa here, my settee, that should stand up. There you go, stood up. That's not even, and he stood up quite happily. Cool feature. Now, one thing I do find though, on high, that's throwing light 360 degrees, and that's throwing it my way. So, adapt and overcome. Piece of black insulation tape, electrical tape, or that. That gives me the option of not blinding myself with the quadrant that's facing me. I'm getting a nice throw somewhere else. Can always mess it off afterwards. But that's one problem of such a powerful little torch and one of these wand things that gives you a lantern. It's too much in your direction if you were using it. What you also get is a little bag, and you get your pocket clip, a little wrench, you get a spare O-ring, and you get a little bolt that connect it to the side for your pocket clip there. Some people are charging a few extra pounds for something like that. It doesn't come with the cells, but I've managed to get myself a big bumper pack of these, so I've always got one that's charged up and one that's in, so I'm not too worried about that. It comes in a crate tin, which is usable again, and once again a really cool package from Frunite. So if you want the option of something around that size and you want a little bit more poke, because these things are very powerful, I do actually like AA and AAA batteries, but it's a bit of an eye-opener when you start going towards these powerful options here, just how much you can get out of a small torch or a flashlight this large. Now, the other thing was when you use your thumb on the top, on those, on one other torch I've got, the entire top, it's got a protective sort of castellated ring around it, so it's quite a challenge to get your thumb up and over. But on these two, it's like crenellated, which is sort of the dip in there, which allows your thumb, whatever goes on, as soon as you get on there, your thumb's hampered on that, where you just feel around and you find the gap and you can find the button on and off, which I find is a lot more user-friendly than when the cap at the top has a ring all the way around it. Yeah, there was one, and it was a real challenge to get your thumb up and over and in. By having the gap on two sides, you're still preventing the accidental pushing on, but it allows a lot better access to your thumb because you can feel where the gap is. So that's from Frunite, the T20. This one comes in a neutral light. It doesn't really look piercing like a bright. It doesn't come across cool. I can't really tell the difference until you put another one of a different sort of ilk up against it. But it doesn't come across as quite an offensive blasting white light. And it's got a touch of warmth to it. I did hear on one of the forums or a review somewhere that someone mentioned that the anodizing was coming off of theirs. Well, in terms of like for like, my little TI3 has been on that for a couple of months, and it's only just beginning. I mean, that's had a battering. Okay, and it's just beginning to lose the tops of the anodizing. So from what I've experienced of the black coating, it takes a pounding. And I love that actual look when it's worn in. It proves it's doing a job you've wanted it to do. It's taking a beating. So I haven't experienced problems with the anodizing yet at all. Thanks again for joining me. That's the initial review of a T20 by Thru-Night, already adapted by Wessex Blades. That's just me. Join me again. See you on the next one.